Hi guys, welcome to Code Bashers. In this video, I will be discussing the coding questions which are asked in TCS Ninja Hiring or you can say TCS NQT. Guys, this is part 3 of this series. Part 1 and 2 are already uploaded on my channel. So make sure that after watching this video, you watch those videos as well. You will get a good idea that how is the level of the coding questions which are asked in this TCS NQT exam. Guys, if you are new to this channel, make sure that you subscribe it because I am posting regular stuff on 2022 batch students. My TCS Digital Coding series is also going on. Till now, I have uploaded 8 parts in that particular series. The link of that series is also given in the description box. So guys, now let's start this video. And before starting a video, please hit the like button as well as the subscribe button for this channel. Okay, so the question here is, we have to display a sequence of Fibonacci series until the number given by the user. First two terms of the Fibonacci series are 0 and 1. So we have to display the Fibonacci series which are starting from 0 and 1. And we have to display the Fibonacci series till the number that is given to us by the user. Now, number given by user for Fibonacci series should be greater than 5 and less than or equal to 20. Otherwise, display invalid input. So, till when we can display the Fibonacci series? If the number entered by user is greater than 5 and it is less than or equal to 20, then only we can print the Fibonacci series. Otherwise, if the number is different from these numbers specified, we have to simply print invalid input. Now, if number given by user is space, character or empty, then we have to display invalid input. The text message should be displayed in exact format as it is case sensitive. Okay, so in other words, if any other thing other than the number in this range, that is 5 to 20 is entered, then we have to display the invalid input. Now we have to display invalid input in all capital because it is case sensitive, and if we will not do this, it will give us wrong output for the particular test cases. Now let's see with an example. So your input is 8 and we have displayed the Fibonacci series. So we know that Fibonacci series starts with 0 and 1. Now 0, then 1, then again 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13. So we have to generate the sequence of Fibonacci series till the terms that has been specified by the users. Now these terms should be in the range between 5 to 20. Now I will tell you that what a Fibonacci series is. Now guys, first two terms are given to us, that is 0 and 1. So what we'll do, we will take two variables A and B and we will assign these values and we will assign 0 and 1 respectively. Now let's see the formula of generating Fibonacci series. So basically the Fibonacci series is, that is the current term, you can say the current term is equivalent to the sum of n minus 1. So let's suppose, okay, so let me just tell you like this way. Okay, so nth term of Fibonacci series is equivalent to n minus 1th term plus n minus 2th term. So this is what the formula of the nth term of a Fibonacci series. So let's suppose we are given two numbers, that is 0 and 1, and we know that Fibonacci series are starting from 0 and 1. So now we have to find the next term. So next term we will assign it as C. So what will be C? C will be equivalent to A plus B, because I have told you the nth term is equivalent to the sum of n minus 1th term plus n minus 2th term. So now C will be 0 and 1, 0 plus 1, that is 1. Now what we have to do? Now we have to find the next term. Now again, what will be the next term? Next term will be equivalent to the sum of the previous term plus the sum of two previous terms, that is this one plus this one. Next term will be given by this one plus this one. So now we just need three variables for doing this particular calculation. So how we'll do it? Now once we have find this particular term, now we have to find the next term. So before finding the next term, what we'll do, we'll simply do A is equivalent to B, then we'll do B is equivalent to C, and then we'll do C is equivalent to A plus B. So C is equivalent to A plus B. Now what is C? 1 plus 1, that is 2. Now we have found this term. Now we have to find the next term. How we can find the next term? That will be equivalent to this term plus this term. So again, what we'll do? We'll first assign A is equivalent to B, then we will assign B is equivalent to C, and then we will do, then we'll find the Cth term. And what will be Cth term? A plus B. And what is A plus B? It is 3. So by this method, we will keep on finding the terms of the Fibonacci series. Now next term will be 5, because 2 plus 3, 5. So we will continue finding this term till we have found these many terms. So how many terms we have found? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 6 term of Fibonacci series is 5. We have to find 8 terms. So 6 term is this. 7 term will be 5 plus 3, 8. And 8th term will be 8 plus 5, 13. So we have to find these number of terms that has been given to us by the user. And this number should be in between 5 to 20. So I hope the entire question is clear to you and how we can find the Fibonacci series. So this was the entire approach. Now I will be writing the code for the same. Okay, so first we have to take the how many terms the user wants. So let's say int n. Just a second, int n. Then we'll do c in n. Okay, so now see there were two things in the question. If the input that has been entered by the user is not between this range, that is, it is not greater than 5 and less than equal to 20, then in all the cases we have to print invalid input. So now what we'll do, we will write the base case. So if our input number, that is n, is either less than equivalent to 5 or the value of n is greater than 20. If this is the case, then what we'll do, we have to simply print invalid input in all caps, invalid input. Now once we have done this, now there is no point in moving ahead of the code, so we will simply return 0 from here. Now this was the case when the range when the input number was not lying in the range of 5 to 20, then we have to print invalid input. Now once it is lying in between this range, then we have to print the Fibonacci series. So how will printing the Fibonacci series? Again, we know that our starting value is int a, and the starting value is 0. Second variable is int b, and our value will be 1, because Fibonacci series starts from 0 and 1. Now we have to find till the nth term that is given to us. So first term is here. First term we have found a is equal to 0, b is equal to 1. Now what we have to do, we have to start with the third term. So for int I is equal to 3, I less than equal to n, I plus plus. Because see, why we are running this loop from I is equal to 3? Because first two terms of the Fibonacci series are with us, and now we have to find the terms. Now we have to find the terms till the nth term. So now what we'll do? First of all, we will calculate c. So int c is equivalent to a plus b. Now see, we have found out c. Now it means we have to print c. Now we print c with space separated. Now see, if we are printing c out in this loop, then the Fibonacci series will be printed with the third term, starting from the third term. But we have not printed first and second term. So what we'll do, we'll simply do c out a and c out b also we will do, because we have to print the first two terms also. So first two terms are printed like this, and then inside the loop we are starting from the third term till the nth term. So first of all, we will be calculating c is equal to a plus b, like we were doing in this particular example. First you are calculating c is equal to a plus b, then we will be printing that c value, and then we will be making the changes. That how we were making changes, we are first simply doing a is equal to b, and then b is equal to c. So once we have done this, inside this loop all the values from the third term till the nth term will be printed in the Fibonacci series, and for printing the first two terms we have simply printed the values of a and b. So guys, I hope the code is clear to you. This will run perfectly fine. So let us just enter an input. So let's just say we want 8 terms only. So our answer should look like this: 0 1 1 2 3 5 8 13. Let's see what is our answer. 0 1 1 2 3 5 8 13. So this is how our answer is printed. Now let's just print that we want just 3 terms in the Fibonacci series. Our answer should be 0 1 1. Okay, so it is giving us 3 again. Yes, why it is giving 3? Because we should give the terms in the range of 5 to 20. So let's just suppose we just want, let's say, 6 terms only. So let's just run on it, and after this test case we will test whether if we input character, what will happen. It should print invalid input in case of character. Now for the 6, it has printed the correct values. 6 terms of Fibonacci series has been printed correctly. Now let's just enter a character. This will be our last test case, and in this particular test case it should give us invalid input, because in any input that is not in the range of 5 to 20 should give us invalid input, and the code for this invalid input is this condition. So guys, You can see that all the test cases which I have shown you are passed successfully, and it will pass all the test cases that will be given to you by TCS. So I hope guys this question as well as the code of this question is clear to you. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Please like this video, share my channel, as well as subscribe this channel.